This is a system of equations that we used in one of the earlier videos to illustrate the use of row operations and the row operations tool to solve a system. I want to now use this same system to illustrate the connection with matrix inverses and also to illustrate use of the matrix tool to calculate a matrix inverse. So now we switch over to the matrix tool, and I'm going to name a matrix capital C, which will be the coefficient matrix of that system. It was x plus y plus 4z in the first equation, 1x, 1y, 4z. The second equation, there was no x term, it was 2y and 5z. And in the third equation, it was 3x, 2y, and 4z. So capital C is my coefficient matrix, and the numbers on the right I'm going to put into a column which I'll call lowercase b. In the first equation it was 2 on the right, in the second equation it was 4, and in the third equation it was minus 7. So let's check and make sure the matrix tool understands these matrices I've entered. Capital C looks right, and lowercase b looks right. What we've seen is that you can solve a system of equations if you take the inverse of the coefficient matrix and multiply it times that column of numbers. The inverse of the coefficient matrix can be calculated in the matrix tool as C to the power, use the little caret symbol for power, and then exponent minus 1, and we want to multiply that times b, lowercase b that is. So we're calculating the inverse of that 3 by 3 matrix C. The inverse will be 3 by 3, and we're going to multiply that inverse times the column b, and that should give us the solutions for x, y, and z in the system of equations. Let's do it. What we get is x equals minus 3, y equals minus 3, z equals 2. Check that indeed that does solve the system of equations.